हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ एसएम माली, लेक्चरर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, गोकटे पीयू कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बेळगावी. वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय 10th लेक्चर ऑन इंडेक्स नंबर्स. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सॉल्व द एग्जांपल्स ऑन कंज्यूमर प्राइस इंडेक्स नंबर. Today we will solve the remaining examples on consumer price index number. Today's first question is, construct consumer price index number by family budget method. Here the data is given 2003 expenses and price are given and 2005 prices are given. Then in the solution, year 2003 is a base year and 2005 is a current year. So expenses we have to denote by W. Then price in the base year is denoted by P0 and price in the current year is denoted by P1. Then we have to find price relatives, that is P equal to P1 divided by P0 into 100, that is 6 divided by 5 into 100, you will get 120. Then similarly 10 divided by 8 into 100 is 125. Then 12 divided by 10 into 100 is 120. 10 divided by 8 into 100 is equal to 125. And the last is 3 divided by 2 into 100 is 150. Then we have to find W into P, that is 60 into 120 is equal to 7200. Then 40 into 125 is equal to 5000. Then 10 into 120 is equal to 1200. 64 into 125 is equal to 8000. And the last is 10 into 150 is equal to 1500. Then if we add all WP values, you will get summation WP is equal to 22900. Similarly, we have to add all W values, then you will get summation W is equal to 184. Then we have the consumer price index number by family budget method is CPI is equal to summation WP upon summation W. So which is equal to 22900 divided by 184. If you simplify this further, then you will get CPI is equal to 124.46. Then come to the second question, that is calculate cost of living index number from the following data. Here data is given, items are given, then group index are given and weights are given. Then in the solution, we have to denote group index by I and weights by W. Then we have to find W into I, that is weights into group index. That is 3 into 110 is equal to 330. Then 8 into 120 is equal to 960. Then 4 into 112 is equal to 448. Then 6 into 108 is equal to 648. And the last is 9 into 105 is equal to 945. Then if we add all WI values, you will get summation WI is equal to 3331. and by adding all W values, you will get summation W is equal to 30. Then we have the cost of living index number formula, CLI is equal to summation WI upon summation W, which is equal to 3331 divided by 30, and after simplification you will get cost of living index CLI is equal to 111.03. Then come to the third question. A family budget inquiry revealed that the average expenditure of the families on food, clothing, rent, fuel and miscellaneous are 30%, 10%, 20%, 20% and 20% respectively. If the respective group indices are 130, 170, 160, 200 and 180, find the consumer price index number. Here, this data we have to write in the tabular form. First, we will consider group, that is food, clothing, rent, fuel and miscellaneous. Then group index are given, that we will write in the tabular form. Respective group indices are given, that we will write here, or expenditure is given, that we will write here. Then group index is denoted by I and average expenditure is denoted by W. Then we will find W into I, that is average expenditure into group index, that is 30 into 130 is equal to 3900, 10 into 170 is equal to 1700, similarly 20 into 160 is equal to 3200, 20 into 200 is equal to 4000, and last is 20 into 180 is equal to 3600. By adding all WI values, you will get summation WI is equal to 16,400. Also, by adding all W values, you will get summation W is equal to 100. Then, we have the consumer price index number formula, that is CLI is equal to summation WI upon summation W. By putting the totals, you will get 16,400 divided by 100, and by simplifying this, you will get cost of living index CLI is equal to 164. Then come to the fourth question. The group indices and the corresponding weights for the working class in an industrial town for the year 2005 and 2010 with base 2000 are given below. Compute consumer price index number. Here the group weights are given and group index for the year 2005 and 2010 are given. Here 2005 and 2010 both are the current years and the year 2000 is a base year. So in the solution, we will denote group weight as W and group index in the year 2005 is denoted by I1 and in the year 2010 is denoted by I2, because both are the current years. Then we will find W into I1, that is 71 into 370 is equal to 26,270. Then similarly 3 into 420 is equal to 1,260. Then 9 into 470 is equal to 4,230. Then 7 into 110 is equal to 770, and the last is 10 into 280 is equal to 2800. Then if you add all WI1 values, then you will get summation WI1 is equal to 35,330. And if we add all W values, you will get summation W is equal to 100. Similarly, we have to find W into I2. That is 71 into 380, you will get 26,980. Then 3 into 500 is equal to 1,500. Then 9 into 340 is equal to 3060. Next is 7 into 120 is equal to 840. And the last is 10 into 282 is equal to 2820. Then if you add all WI2 values, then you will get summation WI2 is equal to 35,200. Then we will find consumer price index number for the year 2000, for the year 2005 with base 2000. We have the formula, that is CPI is equal to summation WI1 upon summation W, which is equal to 35,330 divided by 100. If you simplify this further, you will get CPI is equal to 353.3. This is the consumer price index number for the year 2005 with base 2000. Similarly, we will find consumer price index number for the year 2010 with base 2000. Then we have the formula, CPI is equal to summation WI2 upon summation W, which is equal to 35,200 divided by 100. And if you simplify this further, then you will get CPI is equal to 352. This is the consumer price index number for the year 2010 with base 2000. So these are the examples on consumer price index number. With this example, we have completed the second unit, that is index numbers. From this unit, you will get 1 marks, 2 questions, 2 marks, 2 questions, 5 marks, 2 questions, and 10 marks, 1 question. So total questions from this unit are 1 marks 2, 2 marks 2, 5 marks 2, and 10 marks 1. And total marks from this unit you will get 26. So this unit is completed. Next class, we will deal with the new unit, that is interpolation and extrapolation. Thank you.